Hello everybody, it's Friday, March 15th, let's talk PlayStation. Hey, PlayStation Vita price cut. Kind of. Select Sony stores across America are slashing the price of the 3G PlayStation Vita from $299 to $199. So this is Joystick's news story, and they basically called a bunch of Sony stores to figure out, you know, why, is it permanent, where else is it available, and basically, you know, most Sony stores told them that it's a discontinuation of the 3G model, so therefore a price drop isn't necessarily permanent, they're just trying to get rid of the remaining stock of 3G Vitas. So they called a bunch of Sony stores, and some of them said yes, some of them said no, but for the most part, a lot of them did say yes, it's being discontinued, and it is $199. And a $199 3G PlayStation Vita also comes with an 8GB memory card and a free game if you activate the AT&T subscription plan. If they are in fact discontinuing the 3G PlayStation Vita, good. I mean, really, what was that thing useful for? You couldn't download games more than 20 MB on it. All you could check was email, use the crappy web browser, you know, the Twitter Live, you know, live tweet app. I mean, these are, you know, my smartphone can do this. My Vita's for games. The 3G Vita was completely useless. Because that's what I want to do, Sony. I want to pay AT&T $15 a month so I can check near. Oh, I got some game goods. Not to mention, this might be their way of gauging a price cut in the Western territory by, you know, making 3G Vitas $200, see how many people are going to buy it. Although I'm not sure it'd be that effective considering there's not that many Sony stores in America. There's, like, you know, hardly any at all. So I'm not sure if it would be too effective considering it's not widely available. But hey, if you live near a Sony store and you don't have a Vita yet, $199 for a Vita and an 8GB memory card is not that bad. So while we're on the topic of Vita, let's talk about its sales in Japan. They're still going good. They actually improved last week. And in fact, it was the first week ever this past week that the Vita outsold the 3DS in Japan. First time ever. This includes when the Vita actually came out in Japan. When the Vita launched in Japan, it was still outsold by the 3DS on its launch week. But yeah, this is the first time ever, and that's it's improvement, you know, so maybe we're seeing a little bit of steam trick off here. This past week, Vita sold 63,000 units as compared to 62,000 units last week, so I mean, it's 1,000 more units, but you know, 3DS went down a little bit, so I mean, you know, Vita outsold it, and that's good. It also helps that good games came out recently, like Soul Sacrifice and Dead or Alive 5 Plus in Japan. You know, good games and a price cut seems to be working. Let's get that over to the West. So are you a PlayStation MVP? Who is the top 1% of the PlayStation community? Well, Sony's reaching out to that top 1%. They're sending out emails for people to apply to be a PlayStation MVP. Basically, they sent out this long email to the top 1% of PlayStation gamers. I'm not sure what that necessarily qualifies for. You know, the email kind of hints at it, like trophies and, you know, game activity, how many games you own. Perhaps has to do in conjunction with when they were giving away $10 on PSN, so how many games you bought. We're not necessarily sure what qualifies you to be in the top 1%, but if you get an email, they basically say, you know, oh, you're so cool, man. Thanks for being so cool, and you're so cool. And then they say, like, then they give you an application form to, you know, basically apply to be a PlayStation MVP. As to what that is, I have no clue, and no one else does. I mean, I guess it's awesome on Sony's part that they were giving away $10 on PSN to, like, top buyers, and now they're doing this MVP program. We don't know what it is, but I guess it's sort of cool that they're rewarding players in that respect, you know? So this was making the rounds this week. Jonathan Blow, the developer of The Witness, and he was the developer of Braid, you know, highly acclaimed games. Of course, The Witness was at the PS4 event, and, you know, he came out a little bit talking this week about PS4 and the next Xbox, basically really leaning towards the PS4 side of things in his relationship with Sony. Jonathan Blow makes a couple of comments about the next Xbox, saying it's not strictly about games, and that Microsoft's taking a more multimedia approach, whereas he believes that Sony's in the right by, you know, focusing on the games and game-sharing features and stuff like that. And then he goes on to talk about his working relationship with Sony and Microsoft, and how with Microsoft, it's actually a bit difficult for developers nowadays. Whereas with Sony, it was very easy, and they just kind of took him in and helped him through the whole process to get his games up on PSN, you know, stuff like that. Now, we've known about this for a while. A ton of developers have always said that it's easier to work with Sony rather than Microsoft. It's a pain in the butt to work with them, apparently. And I guess it just speaks volumes about what's going to happen in the next generation, considering PS4 is going to be even more easier to develop on in general. I mean, in this past couple weeks, we've been seeing all these game engines and game studios promising their support on PS4, and that's something we wouldn't have seen with PS3, really. I mean, it took a while for developers to be like, yeah, we'll do PS3, because it's like it's hard to work with that cell, you know, processor, that rough architecture. But combine this with such an easy, you know, processor in the PS4, you know, the x86, something that, you know, is so commonly used, it paints a good picture for Sony and PlayStation 4, but there's still a long road to go. Congrats to Teodoro Mija. I hope I'm saying that right, but he won the PlayStation Plus code, and my God of War Ascension review is coming out later tonight, so watch that. That concludes this week's episode of Let's Talk PlayStation. I'm Ryan Benecki. Thank you for talking with me, and I'll see you next Friday.